Hey guys, welcome back to another Super Metal Brothers React video. I am Super Metal Brother Matt.
And I'm Super Metal Brother Dane.
We are talking Ozzy Osbourne, his latest track that has dropped in forever since ago. Well, it's since Post Malone, I guess, if you count that.
Yes.
This is actually his solo track, whether that was he was appearing on another person's song. This here is him back in the works as Ozzy. Under the Graveyard is the name of this track. We know nothing about this track. We actually haven't played it just yet. But we are familiar, I guess, enough. I guess everyone in the world's honestly familiar with either the Ozzy the character, or at least, you know, some of Ozzy's songs. Danny, from Grand Theft Auto to beyond, what is Ozzy Osbourne sound to you? What do you remember about it?
Yeah, Ozzy, like, even Black Sabbath days, he had him and he had Deer, which were two contrasting, I guess, styles. Ozzy always really had that really great way of being eerie tone and give it a doomy sound and making it quiet, mysterious with his type of singing, his style. I guess a bit more nasy, a bit more high pitch, it makes it a bit more like of that uncomfortable listening too.
Mm.
I say he's not a good singer, it just had his own tone which was different to it.
Absolutely.
And yeah, I guess this time here he has no Zach Wylde on guitars either. He's got some other new gentleman to do his stuff. Again,
that's
I'm
right.
Not sure if he's had this guy for a while or not. Well, there's no Gus G either. So he goes through guitar. So this guy's probably like a gunner as well.
Yeah,
from
absolutely.
Randy Rhoads, you know, Gus G to Zach Wylde. This guy's pretty awesome.
We'll find out if this has a guitar style win it.
Probably
but
not.
All we know for a fact is that Chad Smith from Red Hot Chili Peppers plays drums on it. So.
And bass player from Guns N' Roses.
And bass player from Guns N' Roses. So. Without that though, let's get to this track, I reckon. So let's hit play and see how we go.
Well, the title's an Aussie title, Under the Graveyard. So there's that.
I think Sharon hates her. Maybe you hate yourself enough.
It's a bit folky. It's a bit more Blackmore-y.
Yeah. It does sound it. That sounds very Sabbath. With awesome production.
Yeah, I reckon. Oh, yeah, that sounds Sabbathy. What was that song? Oh, shit.
Yeah, yeah, those bass, like, super tight, super distorted, very ugly sounding.
It's not bad, bit of melee there, bit of grunt when needed. That's the Ozzy there, like ending of notes,
yeah,
or the intervals.
Sounds a little weathered.
No.
His age. I know it seems like that, but he's been doing it for a while.
A bit poppy this part.
Yeah. So although still getting pretty good range at that age. Yeah,
I think he's missing a bit of that power in his vocals to match that part of the song.
Yeah, but even that yeah, section, it's like polished and it doesn't sound like, I mean, if you go full Sabbath, you need that full, you know, take your click off, let everyone just play together. That's where Sabbath, the whole team works for each other. This is like a big production team trying to sound like Sabbath and it's missing the Sabbath magic.
That sound, what is this?
It sounds like Black Sabbath. Black Sabbath does.
That's it.
Did he write the song Sabbath?
No, no, it was Tony.
Yeah. Now I'm like, this song.
Now it's turned out very pop rocky.
This is classic. This is like classic Sabbath, isn't it?
Oh yeah, like Fairies Wear Boots.
Yeah.
Probably playing a caravan or something.
Wow, he just hates Black Sabbath, doesn't he? He's like, I don't want to be Black Sabbath anymore. He's my new band. It's called Ozzy Osbourne, which is doing Black Sabbath songs. He wasn't quite ready to say, let go to it, man.
Oh, is that Ammon organ? It is Blackmore.
Yeah.
So combining Blackmore and a Yomi here.
Yeah, it's definitely a throwback, this track, for sure. With it, like, so that infusion of pop. Absolutely. It's all right.
That stretch, you know, he does.
Yeah.
Oh, he's kept his feel.
That's it.
Oh, yeah.
All right. There you go. Ozzy Osbourne, everyone. Oh, God, no.
That's a weird combination. Just click cancel.
Oh, yeah, sure. Right, there we go. Cool. So that's the Ozzy Osbourne track, Under the Graveyard. Danny, thoughts?
Pretty standard. Nothing too exciting. The verse is just nice, and then the chorus is a bit of melody to it, and the production helps it a lot. That big sound kind of makes it sound very full, because Ozzy himself wasn't really helping support that music, so
yeah,
like he still does his things. He does his nice little like intervals at the end and the stretching note he does. He's got his personality still, but with his age, you know, I guess he's probably the best he can do. I've seen him live, he was a bit off a bit,
yeah,
so maybe they've kind of written songs kind of around his voice, which makes sense. You get older,
like, yeah, absolutely, yeah. You can tell this guy just is hanging on for dear life, like, and he really is at times. You know, yeah, this guy's been in the hospital.
Yeah, last year was really bad,
really scary. You know, and he's come out and he's like, "Nah, I want to be back as being a musician. That's where I'm the most happiest." Yeah. And still singing about fairly grim attire and cultish like themes. And you know, he's just back. You know, he's back doing Aussie stuff. You know, it does feel like a Black Sabbath track throwback, but obviously if you want the real thing, probably go listen to Black Sabbath, I think.
Yeah, of course.
This song feels like a couple of those tracks kind of smushed in. Oh, it sounds like Black Sabbath fans wanted to write a song for Ozzy, and Ozzy's like, yeah, why not, you know? I think, though, you're better suited for Tony Iommi's playing. It's phenomenal, and it really works alongside, and it just gives a bit more lush scape to it, and he's playing, it's very bluesy, you know, and I think these guys are trying to capture that lightning in a bottle. And yeah, even if you get a spark, I guess it's still, you know, decent.
Yes,
but a track for me was a little underwhelming, Danny, I won't be honest. Like, it didn't really leave me with much that I haven't heard before from the guys, and not better. But it is nice to see Ozzy doing well, meaning he's back, and the return is great. Yeah, and if this makes pop music mainstream, then I can't really complain about that too much. So even though this being in existence isn't offending me, it's just like, okay, cool, you know, another track from Ozzy.
Yeah, I think that's pretty much it.
Yeah. Cool. All right, what did you guys think of the latest Ozzy Osbourne track, Under the Graveyard? Let us know. And until then, we'll see you in the next episode. Catch you later.